This Saturday, my daughter started a dance class. So my wife was out of town, I had to take my daughter to dance class, and this is a ballet and tapping type of stuff. So I go in, I'm all nervous, and I'm looking over, and I see that smiling face, so it kind of made me a little bit more, you know, at ease. And we were in there doing little dance poses and the ballet stuff, you know. But I just wanted to share that with you real quick.
Are you going to show us your moves?
I don't know about that.
You guys don't see the ballet?
But, it's an honor to be able to come and speak with you this morning. My name is Jerry Ford. I'm a deacon at United Ordained Church. I'm also the founder of Team Hero, which is a nonprofit organization. Hero stands for helping everyone recognize opportunity. As Ms. Reynolds stated, both of my sons used to go to school here. My youngest son, he recently went up to the middle school. So, when she reached out to me and asked me to come in and speak, I felt real honored that she would, you know, have me come back out. And I'm not going to go over all the statistics because I had some of the stuff that she just said in the PowerPoint. I had that in my mind to speak about, so I'm not even going to go there. But I just want to encourage each and every one of you this morning to become actively involved in your child's life. The other day, I took my car to get serviced, and while we were getting the car serviced, we went into the room that they designate for the children. And my daughter, when we went in the room, there was a TV on the wall. I think it had like doctor stuff and playing or something like that. And there was some toys on the ground, but there was also some books on the table. And my daughter immediately went to the book. She's 3 years old. She went immediately to the books and she said, "Daddy, read." So I read the book. I think it was 10 Ladybugs or something like that. And I read the book to her. And after I finished reading the book, I closed the book, thinking that she was going to go to the toys or maybe she would watch TV. She said, "No, Daddy, read it again." So she was very interested in having me read to her. I see over here to my left, there's a big table of books. So what I'm going to do this morning, I'm going to challenge each and every one of you to walk over there. If you don't have one, grab a book and commit to reading that book to your child. That's my challenge to you this morning. If you don't have a book in your hand before you leave, just walk over there, grab a book, and commit to reading that book to your child. That statistic that she said about the brain being 90% developed before the age of 5, that just blew my mind. Because that's before they even come to school. So a lot of what they're learning is being taught by us at home before they even come into school. And we should really just pay attention to that. So grab a book. She said that there's some letters over there. I also have some resource material. I'm very active at the Troy Boys and Girls Club. I run a program called the Block Center. We deal with the young people from ages 11 to 17. So we're catching the young teens, the preteens, before they get out into the street. We're pouring into them. We're sharing some of our life stories with them. Me personally, really quick, I did come from a traditional home. My mother and my father, they were both crack cocaine addicts. They eventually died of HIV. I lost my mother when I was like 9 years old. I lost my father when I was about 20 years old. He was never a part of my life. So in my mind, I made up that what I wanted to do was going to be different from what my father did. And when I look around and I see all y'all faces this morning, I see you guys have made up your minds too that you're going to be involved in your child's life. So once again, I commend you, but I also challenge you to grab one of those books and read it to your child. Thank y'all for letting me speak to you this morning.